If you've ever played paintball, more likely than not, you've had the opportunity to play on a speedball field or an airball field. I would like to know how these bunkers are manufactured, so come with me to Phoenix, Arizona, to Airups Bunker Systems, and let's see how these paintball bunkers are manufactured. Before your bunker can begin, if you want your logo on it, the first step is to go through the design process. The design starts on a large-scale printer, which can be fully color sublimated, or you can have your bunker silkscreened. Besides having your custom logo on it, you can choose from just about any color under the rainbow. The vinyl material is stretched across a very large working space with all of the shapes already predetermined on the table to ensure consistency with every bunker shape. For these starting bunkers, a second color of black vinyl was chosen to go around the side to give it some contrast. Once all the pieces are cut, the side panels get stacked and the slit gets cut for the D-link, as well as the hole for the bunker plug itself. Next, a worker takes several layers of vinyl, puts it on a stamp, and die cuts out the D-link assembly.
Alright, after the parts are punched, we take two parts, put them together, and then the D-ring gets inserted onto it. And this gets put behind. We actually do use a heavy-duty nickel-plated D-ring, a number 6. And then after that, it gets radio frequency'd on. And then from there, it goes onto the bunker.
Once the D-link assembly is attached to the side panel, a high-frequency welder is used to permanently bond the D-link assembly to the bunker, making it one of the toughest points on the bunker. The same process of radio frequency welding is also used for the bunker plug and the flap that covers the bunker plug. Now that the material has all of the necessary attachments, it is now time to put them all together in the process called welding. An operator now takes the front panel and the side panel, joins them together, and is ready to run them through the welder. The two pieces of vinyl go through the rollers, getting superheated. This forms an instant bond. Because of this process, this is what makes Airups bunkers the most durable bunkers on the market today. The only thing now is to air them up, let them sit overnight, and make sure there is no small leaks or pinholes before they get shipped out to customers worldwide and enjoyed for years to come.